I'm Samuel Temitope Akode, Associate and Young Adult Pastor of Faith Baptist Church and the Editor of Eye Opener Magazine. In the first episode of my series on Now That You Are Less Busy, I did mention that now that you are less busy, what will you do with prayer? This is the second episode of the same series, Now That You Are Less Busy. And like I stated in the first episode, almost every one of us is less busy at this time due to the ongoing pandemic, except for our health workers and few other essential workers. The rest of us have a lot of time at our disposal. Now that you are less busy, what will you do with Bible reading and meditation? Before now, I have had people complain of not being able to spend much time in reading the Word of God, while others have complained of not having time at all to even read the Word of God due to the very busy schedule. Some have talked about how much they love reading the Bible, but don't have ample time needed to do so. The Bible says, "This book of the law shall not depart out of thy mouth, but thou shalt meditate therein day and night, that thou mayest observe to do according to all that is written therein. For then thou shalt make thy way prosperous, and then thou shalt have good success." That's Joshua chapter 1, verse 8. As we transcend through this pandemic, you will do yourself a lot of good by feeding your soul with good dosage of God's word, which will help keep your heart at peace. Great peace have they which love thy law, and nothing shall offend them. Psalm 119 verse 165 says, the situation out there will make our heart faint, but there is always hope in God's word. My soul fainted for thy salvation, but I hope in thy word. That's Psalm 119 verse 81. Now that you are less busy, what will you do with Bible reading and meditation?